Hello and welcome to MC Media presenting the Yarmouth Cooks Cup Tournament here at the Yarmouth Mariners Center. CJ Killam with the call, about to get underway between West King's Wolverines in red, taking on the Digby Mariners in green. Competitive game getting ready to go underway. Digby losing their first game to Parambá, but scored 6 goals in the process. And West Kings losing their first game to Barrington. The Barons have a very tough team this year. It's been playing very well. West Kings only scoring 2 in that one. There seems to be a bit of a delay going on right now on the ice. Just a heads up, mcmedia.stream. That's where you can watch all of our games. We have every single Cooks Cup game live tonight and throughout the weekend. And then all the games are archived up, mcmedia.stream. Now we're finally underway. And off the opening faceoff, puck now in the Mariners zone. Digby. Sending the puck in the attacking zone, and now it's the Wolverines looking to go on the attack. Here come the Wolverines. Sending that one up to the point. And a big hit thrown early here by the Mariners. But the Mariners still in their own zone. It's dumped in, and now here comes the Mariners carrying that one all the way deep. Puck comes out in front of the net. Now with play being whistled dead. And net for the West Kings Wolverines. It's Kerrigan Allen. Probably the smallest goaltender in this tournament. It's typically you see nowadays of goaltenders, it's always the tallest guy ever since guys like Roberto Luongo, Rick DiPietro, and such have made splashes in the NHL. That pass, though, unable to be touched up by the Mariners, so it goes all the way down for icing. And opposite him in net for the Digby Mariners, it's Jacob Murphy. Murphy, a bit of a tough game against Parambá, let in 9 goals, but made some fantastic saves. As Parambá, a very highly potent offensive team. Hand pass, play now. Whistle dead again, and gonna face off now, gonna come right in front of the Mariner bench. Another big hit being thrown by the Digby Mariners, who looked to make a statement in the physicality department early. Now Wolverine's trying to get on the counterattack, but can't get out past their own blue line. Wolverines now just having difficulty getting out of their own zone. Digby with it now, trying to pass it up. Now here come the Wolverines. Wolverines coming on a shot, goes right into the glove of Murphy, who hangs on for the faceoff. And here come the Mariners. Partial break coming in. Gets hauled down. It's a tripping call. And now the Mariners going to be going on a power play advantage. Thought that might have been a penalty shot. It was a partial breakaway. He was clean on the goaltender. But Digby just going to get the extra man advantage. It's number 16, Carson Harper, in the box. Mariners now looking to move the puck around. The Wolverines able to take it and carry it up. The Wolverines send that one all the way down as they've killed off 30 seconds so far on the power play. Mariners now trying to regroup in their own zone. Now it's Acker with it. Here comes Acker, coming in on the attack. Gets held up though. Point shot, just going wide of the net. Now Digby has it behind the net. It's Trimper. Trimper with the puck, sending it out in front, but goes onto the stick of a Wolverine. Digby still with possession. Now try to dump it up and in. Now here come the Mariners. It's one on three. He's getting around, takes the shot, easily handled by Allen. Mariners still with it, cross-ice pass. No one gets a stick on it. And the Wolverines able to clear it out. 25 seconds left on the power play for the Digby Mariners. Digby with it now. Takes the shot. That one gets blocked. Murphy fans on it, and just like that, the Wolverines put that one in the net. It's number 96, Ben Foley. Murphy makes a hard mistake. It's not fresh ice, the flood coming after this period, so Murphy trying to pass that one up. Can't get it out and through. You'll see here on the replay. Or not, as now play back underway. As here come the Wolverines back on the attack. Oh, excuse me, it was number 95, Bryce Oliver, who put that one in. Off of a mistake from Jacob Murphy, who played well against Parambá, let in about 9 goals. It's not often you could say a goaltender played well letting in that many goals, but they were all hard-earned goals. Not much you could do on any of them. Now it's the Wolverines continuing to put the pressure on. Looking to answer right back after putting in the first one. That centering pass goes off of a skate. Now here comes the Mariners again, but can't get through all the sticks of the Wolverines. Wolverines now looking to go on a counterattack. Here's the replay now. The fan by Murphy then overskates the puck. And then it was Oliver able to reach to that one just in the nick of time. Just a miscommunication there and a mistake from the goaltender and the defenders, who two defenders around Murphy, but none of them checked Oliver, who was racing towards the net. Shot from the Wolverines, kicked aside by Murphy. And now here come the Digby Mariners, cross-ice pass out of reach of the intended target. And now Wolverines now looking to go the other way. Here comes West Kings. Shot from the point going wide. And now here come the Wolverines. Backhanded shot, saved by Murphy. And the puck cleared away by the Mariners. And here comes Digby. Coming back on the attack, but a step offside are the Mariners. So we're going to have ourselves another faceoff. Low shot affair so far, halfway through the first. Just three shots for the Wolverines, one for the Digby Mariners. Wolverines try to clear the puck out of their own zone. Now they look to carry it out. Here comes West Kings. West Kings can't hold the line, and now Digby coming on the counterattack. Here come the Mariners. Shot deflected wide. Comes out in front, but can't get through Allen. Another shot. That one blocked. The rebound saved by Allen, who holds on for the faceoff. And now two guys, both going in the box now for a head contact. Offsetting Miners now going against both teams. Now it's the Wolverines with the puck in their own zone. Now carrying it up. Here comes West Kings. A lot of speed coming in towards that. A shot saved by Murphy. It's Acker now for Digby. Carrying it up, but pushed off the puck. Wolverines dumping that one right back in. And now it's Wolverines getting back on side, carrying this one back in. Wolverines shot, and that one deflecting just wide of the net. Wolverines sending that one up to the point, a point shot saved by Murphy. Puck gets deflected up and out of the Mariners' zone. And now Acker trying to get around his defender, but pushes the puck too far and back to Allen. Now a shot, that one going high and against the glass. And now here comes the Wolverines. They get held up at neutral ice. West King's going to take a second attempt trying to get through. And then they go back into their own zone. Here comes the third attempt, and they just dump that one in. West King's with it now. Has the puck poked away. Now the Mariners look to go the other way. Can't get past the blue line. Now they look to carry it up and through, and they do. They have it poked away. And now the Wolverines are going the other direction. Mariners, though, hold them up at their own blue line and dump the puck right back in. Shot from outside of the blue line, hits a body in front and goes into the corner. Here come the Wolverines. Can't get through the defense of the Mariners. Acker now with the puck behind his own net. Sends it up to Trimper. Puck now dumped in. And hit now. That's going to be another penalty. And it's a kneeing call going against Acker. Pretty easy call for the referee to make there. So now the Wolverines going to get their first power play in this game. Penalty kill for the Digby Mariners was very good against Parramba. Even though Parramba scored 9 goals and they had about 5 power play opportunities and didn't convert on any of them. And now here comes the Wolverines. Alone in front and a save by Murphy, and the rebound though gets through. Wolverines quickly responding on the power play. It looks to be possibly number 4. Nope, it's hard to see. He's using the tuck-in jersey, so only half of his number is visible. But that might be number 28 or maybe 29. Can't see the bottom of his jersey. But now the Mariners look to respond quickly here, but the net coming off its marks. Face off one by the Mariners. But they quickly turn it over to the Wolverines, who are putting on a good forecheck. Now Mariners looking to go the other way. Here comes Digby. Tried to put on a fancy move, but couldn't maintain control. Now it goes up to the point. The shot gets blocked. Tries it again. That one almost gets through. Third time's the charm. That one, though, goes wide. Puck coming out in front. And that last goal was scored by number 28, Owen St. Nicholas, getting that one. A lost edge and a collision along the boards. And now that's going to be a penalty. Trip now going against number 17, Jordan Etheridge. And now Digby going to get a power play. 2:25 left in the first. Etheridge in the box for a trip. And off the faceoff, it's the Wolverines able to clear it all the way down. Puck, though, being left out in front of Murphy. And another good opportunity for the Wolverines to try to pounce on it. Puck was left sitting just to the side of Murphy. Hunter almost pounced on it, but Digby defender, luckily for him, able to get a stick in front of that one. It deflects up and out of play. Now here come the Mariners. Tried for a centering pass. Couldn't get through the sticks in front of them. Back down the ice it goes. Now it's the Wolverines dumping that one in. And now it's the Mariners with it, passing that one up. Can't get through the neutral ice, and the Wolverines send it all the way back down. Now here comes Acker. Digby still on the power play. Good shot by Acker. Kicks it up to his stick. But a good save there by Allen. Centering pass. Bounced off the back of the net. Allows the Wolverines to clear it all the way down. And that will probably do it for the power play advantage. Digby unable to convert on the power play. Now back to even strength with 20 seconds left here in the first. Here comes Wes Kings. Coming in on the attack. Can't get through the defense of the Mariners. Digby still with it. Moving it along. And they send it up. Here comes Mariners. Might have time for one last shot, but loses the handle on it. And now more extra stuff being thrown as it was a late hit. It's causing a commotion between both teams. So there'll probably be extra penalties handed out after this one. The Zamboni coming out for a flood. Score right now, West Kings Wolverines 2, Digby nothing. And we will be back for the start of the second. You are watching the Cook's Cup tournament brought to you by MC Media. We'll be back for the rest of this game. Hello, and you are watching the Cook's Cup, brought to you by MC Media. CJ Killam with the call. And it's currently the West Kings Wolverines leading the Digby Mariners 2-0. But an end of the period scrum resulting in a lot of penalties. Three players in the box for Digby, two for the Wolverines, resulting in West Kings having a power play. Last time West Kings had a power play, they scored in just the first 10 seconds, and that gave them this two-goal lead. But now it's the Mariners coming in shorthanded, a lot of speed, but gets pushed away, but draws a penalty. That's the second time in this game, number 21, Logan Bell, used his speed to get past a defender and drew a penalty. So just like that, Wolverines penalty gone, and we're down to four on four hockey. Now it's a race for the puck, won by the Digby Mariners. Sent all the way down by West Kings, but that one is going to be icing. Oh, good opportunity for the Mariners as the puck comes right out in front of Allen, but unable to get that one on net. Now it's the Wolverines, the puck in their own zone. 40 seconds of 4-on-4 hockey left. Here come the Wolverines. Not much power on that shot, easily handled by Murphy. Digby with the puck now. Digby able to get that one through, and now it's another race for the puck. Here comes Titus. Good job, though, by West Kings to recover. Digby in the midst of a change, so that pass goes all the way back down into the Mariners' zone. Another bad giveaway by Digby. Puck loose in front. A good block by the Mariners to get in the way of that one. Digby still with it, trying to carry it in, but that one, a little bit of a delay, and that will result in an offside. Puck now being held along the boards. Both teams in there digging for it. Finally, it comes out as we're now back to even strength hockey. 5-on-5 for the first time in this period. A quick shot and a good save by Murphy. Now it's Digby with it. Coming in, backhanded shot, didn't have any power on it. That puck cleared and sent all the way down. Icing waved off. So the Mariners regrouping in their own zone. Now, here come the Mariners. A shot, that one going just wide of the net. And now Wolverines looking to go the other way. But the forward passed, out of reach. But the Wolverines dump that one right back in. Digby now trying to clear that one out. The Wolverines whiff it again. And now it's the Mariners. Here come the Mariners. We get that one taken away. Both teams now fighting for that puck. Along the outside, Wolverines come up with it. Here comes the West Kings trying to come back in on the attack. Digby, though, holds them up at center ice. And now it's Digby. Still with it. Now in their own zone. That pass intercepted, and now Wolverines coming in on the attack. Here come the Wolverines. Shot saved by Murphy, who covers up for the faceoff. Mariners trying to clear the puck off of the faceoff. They do, but that one's going to be icing as it bounces off the side of the net. Shot by the Wolverines, saved by Murphy. Wolverines now still have the puck behind the net. Centering pass, puck loose, somehow doesn't get it go through. Digby clears out again, but again it's another icing for another faceoff. Puck now being moved through neutral ice, and the Wolverines coming in on the attack. But they give it away over to the Mariners. Now Digby trying to carry this one in, get some offense going. But now it's the Wolverines with it, coming in on the attack. But a good poke check by the Mariners, moves that puck away. Kept in, though, by the Wolverines. Both teams now fighting for that puck along the boards, neither able to seem to get control. Centering pass, can't get through all the legs in front. And now finally the puck comes out, and it's on the Digby stick. Here comes the Mariners. Gets by one defender. Two on one. Shot. A good blocker save by Allen. The rebound can't be sent towards the net. Mariners still with it. That point shot is blocked. And now Digby just dumps it down and in along the boards. Digby still with it. Sends it towards their own bench. And that might be a too many men call. And it is indeed. The puck hit a skater for Digby who was going into the bench, and that's a too many men on the ice call. Going against the Digby Mariners. So a bad break there for the Wolverines. Now, it's West Kings on the power play. They can't get through the Mariner defense, who now send it all the way down the ice. A very low shot affair in this one. Halfway through the game, 8 shots for West Kings, just 4 for Digby, 12 shots in total. Last game, Parumba registered 18 shots in the first period. Now here come the Wolverines. Now in their own net, look to break it out, but lost an edge and gave it right back to the Mariners. Now here comes the Wolverines. Wolverines, though, lose the handle and instead decide to go for a change. They get the puck back at their own blue line. St. Nicholas now trying to carry that one up. Wolverines send the puck back to the point. Now they have it along the far boards. Coming in, a shot saved by Murphy. The rebound cleared away by Digby. Here comes St. Nicholas now. Shoots, and that shot going wide. Digby still with it. Tried for a centering pass. No one can get the stick on it. Teams now fighting for that puck as we're back to even strength. Wolverines still with it, sent it cross ice, has some space, shoots up and over the net. Another shot is blocked. Wolverines have it in their own zone. Forward pass out of reach. The Mariners send that one all the way down. Now here come the Wolverines. Gets by one defender, but loses the handle. It's still a race for it. Wolverines still with the puck. But they give it right back to the Mariners, who clear it back and into neutral ice. Puck now loose in front of Murphy. Mariners able to recover. Now it's another race for the puck. West Kings try to leave it, but can't hold on to it. Mariners with it again in neutral ice. This time they lose the possession and have to just dump it back in. Now back into Digby's zone. That pass off its mark. Gives the Wolverines a chance, but that one comes in offside. Now a penalty coming against the Wolverines. I didn't see what the call was, but it's going against number 16, Carson Harper. And a quick shot off the faceoff saved by Allen. Digby now trying to get their first goal in this one on the power play. Faceoff goes all the way across with the shot from the point going wide of the net. Now it's Digby still with it. They send it back down the Wolverine zone, but West Kings just clear that one all the way back down into the Digby zone. Now here comes the Mariners looking to go on the attack. Here comes Digby. Shot saved by Allen. Digby, though, still with it. Another shot sent aside again by Allen. The rebound goes behind the net. Mariners trying to cycle that puck along the boards. Now it's another penalty coming up against the Wolverines. It's a cross check. So now Digby going to have a 5-on-3 for 58 seconds. It's their best offensive opportunity of the game. Off the faceoff, it's won by the Wolverines, who dump it all the way back down into the Mariners' zone. A giveaway, though, by Murphy. Almost results in offensive opportunity, but the Wolverine skater skated over the puck. And now the Mariners trying to break out in their own zone, but that forward pass out of reach, and the Wolverines send it all the way back down. Race for the puck won by West Kings. He's doing some good job on the forecheck, killing off some more time on the power play. Now here comes the Mariners, but they lose the handle and back down the ice it goes, and that'll do it for the 5-on-3. Back to 5-on-4, 55 seconds left on the power play for the Mariners. Here comes Acker. For Digby, gets around one man, trying to carry out and push it through, but Allen covers up for the faceoff. Now it's the Wolverines off the faceoff. They control and send that one all the way down onto Murphy. The rebound, though, won by the West Kings Wolverines, but they couldn't get a quality shot off. So more good forechecking on the penalty kill, killing off more time. Here comes a shorthanded opportunity, but couldn't connect on the pass. Another shot saved by Murphy, and the rebound taken behind the net. Here come the Mariners, but poked away, and that'll do it. Another good, successful penalty kill by the Wolverines. Now have 20 seconds left in the second. Dump in now. Mariners with the puck behind their own net. And they clear it out. Now here they come, two on one. Here come the Mariners. Shot bouncing wide of the net. And that'll do it for the second. No score in the second period. But the West Kings Wolverines still ahead 2-0. Shots right now 12 for the Wolverines, 8 for the Digby Mariners. A very low shot affair, a defensive battle going on between both of these teams. Especially considering the amount of penalties being handed out in this tournament. Both Digby and West Kings taking a lot of penalties, a lot of power play time in that. Probably more special teams time than we were even strength. But even still, very low shot total, just 20 between both of them. For comparison, the previous game, Paramba was almost at 30 shots at this point in the exact same game by themselves. And these two teams, they're playing such a strong game defensively. That quality chances are hard, not just quality chances are hard to come by, but shooting chances are hard to come by. So now we'll see if the Digby Mariners are able to come back. They almost came back against Paramba. They were down by 6 at one point in the third and brought it down to a 3-goal differential. Let's see if they can repeat that as a shot and another save by Allen, who Digby is still trying to solve. Let's see if the Mariners offense able to start connecting here. Scored 5 goals in the last third period they played. Digby now trying to create that offensive opportunity. Send it cross ice. But that one almost was played offside, had to let up, and now the Wolverines took advantage. West Kings dump that one in. Digby, though, can't get it past the blue line. Pushed in and kept deep by the Wolverines, but now Mariners finally able to recover. Titus, though, can't get by the defender in front of him. Cross ice it goes. And the Mariners just dump that one in as defensemen go for a change. Wolverines now looking to carry this one up. Here comes West Kings. West Kings still with it. Shoot and a save by Murphy. Centering pass. Goes all the way out to the blue line. Another forward up passing opportunity for the Mariners, but that one gets intercepted and dumped back in by the Wolverines. Now here comes Acker. Acker takes a shot right into the glove of Allen, who holds on for the faceoff. 13:09 left here in the third. And just off the faceoff, it's Acker. Wins the faceoff and takes the shot. And Digby gets their first goal in this one. That's Dawson Acker's second goal of the tournament to bring this to a 1-goal differential. See here on the replay, and just a perfectly clean one by Acker. Doesn't try for the faceoff wins, tries for the faceoff shot. And he succeeds, he catches Allen napping. Faceoff once again won by Digby. And now it's Acker coming in. Out in front, a shot, scores! just like that, it's a tie game. Digby Mariners back-to-back shots, back-to-back goals. Watch the replay. Great individual effort by Acker. But I believe it's number 16 who was able to follow through on Acker's great individual effort to put that one through. Now let's see if the Mariners can continue the momentum going. Now it's Titus. That shot, though, goes up, but bounces right in front of Allen, but no one there to get the stick on it. Another shot, that one deflects and bounces wide. That puck, though, gets deflected up and into the netting. With Digby once again's offense turns on in the third. You always want the third period to be your best one. And that's ringing true so far for the Digby Mariners here in the Cook's Cup tournament. But now here come the West Kings Wolverines, 2-on-1. Shot scores! Just like that, the Wolverines have the lead back. A 2-on-1 opportunity. And that looks to be scored by number 3. That's number 3, Logan Bastock. Getting that one. Wolverines looking to go back on the counterattack. Now, here comes Digby back on the attack. It's Acker. Back and forth action continuing to happen here. Shot total, 13 each for both teams. It was still been a defensive battle in the first previous periods. But the teams have already eclipsed the goal total in the first and second, in the third. And we're not even a third of the way through this period. A big hit and both arms instantly up by the refs. And now the extra stuff going on. So there might be a few more to call after this. Player still down on the ice for the Wolverines. Player still being looked at along the ice. It was a hard collision in the corner away from the play. I didn't quite see what happened on that hit, but player still down, and definitely one skater for the Wolverines took exception to that hit. Referees conversing right now. And that is the game. And that is it for, I believe, number 21, Bell, going into the locker room. And now back onto his feet, skating to the bench. Still waiting to see what the exact penalty call is. Someone going in the box for the Mariners. And it's a five-minute major being handed out. Referee still conversing with the timekeeper and the coaches. See who's going in the box, and it's my mistake. It was number 16, Lance Thibodeau, one of the goal scorers in this one, who got the game for that hit and a five-minute major. And 2 5-minute majors being handed out. Oh, excuse me. Timekeeper having some troubles down there. Keeps throwing penalties up and taking them down. But after all that, it looks like the Wolverines are going to have 5 minutes of uninterrupted power play. So now action now about to get underway. Wolverines with a great opportunity to maintain their lead and get an extra. And now another player being shown the door. That's number 8, Parker for West Kings being shown the door. Now another one for Digby. It looks like to be number 22, Brandon Brooks, also being shown the door in that one. Bench is a little lighter now. We're underway with the 5 minute major power play opportunity. That shot goes up and over the net. And just like that, some good passing by the Wolverines. I believe that was St. Nicholas at the side of the net, unmarked, who scores the first goal in this 5 minute power play just 30 seconds in. So in St. Nicholas with his second goal of the night. And now there's still 4 minutes and 32 seconds left on the clock. That shot turned aside by Murphy. That centering pass goes off of the skates in front. And now, here come the Wolverines. That shot sent aside by Murphy. It's the Mariners trying to clear it out. Held in at the point, though. West Kings now going back on the attack. That shot saved by Murphy. Gloves it for the faceoff. 3:37 left on the power play. Face off. Won by the Wolverines. Initial save made by Murphy. The rebound, though, no one able to pull the trigger. The Mariners able to clear the zone. Wolverines continuing. Still with it, carrying it, weaving through, shoots and scores. It's number 22. Number 22, James Hunter. Getting that one, a little bit of an excessive celebration right in front of Digby's net afterwards. It's not going to endear him to Digby team at all. Still 8 minutes, 50 seconds left. And still 2:45 now on the major penalty. Again, major penalties. Uninterrupted power play action. Doesn't matter how many goals you score. It's the full 5 minutes. Here they come, a shot. A save by Murphy, the rebound still on the sticks of the Wolverines, and Murphy finally able to cover that one up for the faceoff. Face off, won by the Wolverines. First shot from the point blocked. Second one goes high over the net. Wolverines still with it, carrying it in. Shot goes through. Now it's a 4-goal lead. It's number 17, Jordan Etheridge. Scoring that one. Score now 6-2 in favor of the Wolverines. Still 2:07 left on the penalty. Murphy just screened in front. No chance for him to even see that one. Now the Wolverines, we'll see if they can continue to put on the pressure, but here comes Digby shorthanded. And now here come the Wolverines. Shoot, miss on the breakaway, and couldn't lift the rebound over the pad. Now it's Digby with the puck. They carry out of the zone. And that one going all the way down to Allen, who leaves that for his teammate. Wolverines now looking to go the other way. Here they come. West Kings going right back on the attack. Passed over, alone in front, shoots and scores. 95, Bryce Oliver, second of the night. And that will bring in running time. 5-goal lead in the third. The clock will continue to run. 4 goals scored on this 5-minute major. Just when the Digby Mariners were looking to possibly bring in a comeback, they tied it. And now, 5-goal lead. And here comes West Kings yet again. Still on the power play for another 30 seconds. Now Acker looking to go the other way. Here comes Acker. Gets through both defenders, but lost the puck in the process. Both teams now digging for that puck in the corner. Neither seeming able to come up with it. And that shot bounces off the skater in front. And now, as we're on even strength, the Wolverines send that shot kicked aside by Murphy. Mariners now looking to go the other way, but stood up by Spencer Brecken at the line. And now another penalty coming up against the Mariners. That one going to be a trip. No, a slash. Here's that replay on that huge hit there from Brecken right in front of his own bench. And now it's Acker going in the box for the slash. 3 minutes in running time, an extra minute added on power play advantages. Wolverines now back on the power play, get the puck. Had a great opportunity for St. Nicholas to get the hat trick, but can't send that one through. And now it's another penalty, and here comes the rough stuff. Now two more players being sent into the box. One slash was called, and I thought I saw a cross check as well. We can see what the timekeeper puts up. Should be 4-on-4. Clock continuing to run. They're now 4-on-4 hockey. It's number 17 getting the 2 minutes. Now here comes St. Nicholas. Shoots off the mask of Murphy. That one's going to rattle him a bit, because those type of shots always do. Off the face-off, the Mariners win it and send that one down for icing. Icing waved off as it bounced off of Allen. And here comes the Wolverines, but held up along the boards by the Mariners. Wolverines, though, regain possession, are carrying it back down. Wolverines now have possession at their own blue line. Almost gave it away. As a Mariner forechecker continuing to go after the puck. And now the Mariners are on the power play. Wolverines just dump that one in all the way down onto Murphy. Now it's Acker with it. Acker sitting that one cross ice. And the Wolverines send it right back down. 50 seconds left on the power play for the Digby Mariners. And here they come. Digby just trying to get some momentum on their side after what was almost a great comeback for them. They tied the game up. Let one go in. And then a 5-minute major. West King's able to put 4 in the back of the net to bring the score where it's at. Wrap around by the Mariners. No one can get a stick on it. Puck now just being held against the boards. Going to kill off the rest of this clock, but the Mariners come up with it. Shot by Digby. Gets blocked, and now Wolverines looking to go the other way. And a big hit, and that's going to be another boarding penalty. That's a boarding call going against the Digby Mariners. Penalty trouble, really the main issue for Digby, as they're easily the most penalized team here in the first period. They took a lot of penalties, gave 6 power play opportunities to Parumba. The Sharks unable to convert. And I've lost count of the amount of penalties that Digby has taken in this one. Just 29 seconds left. A boarding call taken by Adam Peck. Face off one by the Wolverines. Shot saved by Murphy. Now the Mariners looking to carry this one out. Long shot on Allen, kicked aside. Another hit as this game continuing to get chippy. And that'll do it for this one. West Kings Wolverines win 7-2 over the Digby Mariners. Digby almost pulling the comeback early in this one, but penalty trouble spelt the end for them. And that'll do it for day one here at Cook's Cup. Been a big day, fantastic one. We saw a lot of great hockey. We'll be back tomorrow morning at 9, Barrington versus Parumba. You've been watching Cook's Cup on MC Media. On behalf of myself, CJ Killam, those behind the booth, in the booth, behind the cameras. We'll see you next time.